Okay, we're live. So we're in a food court at the Prudential Center next to AWP. Indeed. And I have BJ Hollars here, who we read last week. You're reading right now.
Skimming. Don't read the whole thing. I wouldn't read the second one at all, but
we've got some questions that you guys had for him, and I added a couple more. So BJ, why write about monsters, or why write about them so much?
Yeah.
Because you have the essays we're reading, and then also the anthology, right?
Yeah. And I was trying that middle grade novel with monsters. So I'm about monsters in all its forms, first of all. But thank you for reading it. If you did read it, that's great. If you skimmed it, that's good too. I appreciate it. I guess for me, I like monsters because it's sort of unknown, sort of mysterious. You can kind of go in a lot of different directions, and I've always been interested in like the borders between fiction and nonfiction, and so monsters are kind of a perfect representation of that line between the real and the unreal. I was just telling you, I find all these like free classic books you can get on the Kindle because they're like published before a certain year, so you can just get them for free. And I downloaded one called like The Book of Werewolves, and it's like a nonfiction account about werewolves of the 19th century.
So nonfiction.
Yeah. And it's just it's amazing to see like they're like talking about like medical studies, and like in Vienna there was this new case study in 1860 of werewolves, and it's just like this is reported as fact, and they talk about werewolves like it's just like something that's like an extinct species, like a dodo bird, like it was around but now it's gone. And it's just, it's really fun to see those lines. So I've always been kind of interested in how monsters do kind of ride that line between truth and not exact truth, and maybe that's why I'm interested in them.
Cool.